The Wally Show podcast is our daily radio show heard live through the WayFM app each morning and hosted by Wally, Gavin, and me, Betty Rock. For more fun, be sure to connect with us at wayfm.com/Wally.
The Wally Show podcast is brought to you by Colorado Christian University Online, where you can earn a degree online just like Betty Rock. You can learn more at ccu.edu/Wally. She's the smartest girl on the show.
I have a question.
It's News-ish with Betty Rock on The Wally Show.
At the beginning of the year, you make that New Year's resolution with every good intention of sticking with it. But as January progresses, your will to stick with it diminishes.
It gets harder every day. I'm trying to lose a few pounds, yes. And my wife is too. And my wife's like, you know what? We can still just enjoy a day if I come up and have lunch. I'm like, no. I'm like no, because if I enjoy one day, I'm going to enjoy 1, 2, 10.
And we were talking about that, yeah, because you are black and white.
Yes.
Like, you're like, I'm either in or I'm out.
Yeah.
Where there's no gray, there's no moving area, and you're just like, no. Can't do it now, and I can't do it ever.
I know, so I have to stay in, or else I know. No, I know this is going to end.
For sure.
And it will crash badly.
Yes, of course.
It will end up with me face down in a bucket of Oreos,
well,
I'm sure.
It came close because Gavin decided to go and grab himself some McDonald's, and he let me have a couple of fries, and Wally and Marty, his wife, are like, let me just smell it. And then I hold it to Wally's nose, and he took a bite.
Yeah, she held the fries out. I take a big bite. I get some of the fries, and Betty, the best was Betty's like, oh, and then my wife, as I'm eating that fry, goes, well, you could have shared it with me. I'm like, oh my gosh, that is the epitome of everybody's diet and how it feels.
Yeah, exactly. So maybe you found yourself in this situation. You're considering giving up that New Year's resolution. And if you're one of those, then I have a few tips for you on how to power through. So one of those first tips is think about what you have accomplished.
Yes.
Let's say you wanted to go to the gym every day and you've made it maybe 2 days out of the week. Yeah, but you got there 2 days out of the week, which is more than what you've done before in the past. Or maybe you're trying to lose weight and so you're doing the I didn't diet, yeah, like Wally, and you ate half of the burrito instead of the whole burrito.
That's what I did last night. I got rid of the other half just to not be tempted. I put it in the trash so I wouldn't eat it. And even Betty knows that's dodgy because sometimes I've eaten out of the trash.
Oh, gosh. Another tip is remember that progress isn't always linear. And setbacks do happen, but that doesn't mean that you failed.
See, that's my wife's thing. She's like, it's okay. You can have a bad day. And I'm like, no, I can't.
Yeah, but keep in mind, progress isn't always linear.
That's very true.
And it doesn't mean that you failed.
Yeah.
And then finally, instead of giving up totally, just be more realistic with your resolution and adjust where you can. So maybe you're finding yourself just giving in more, or you're just a miserable person to be around.
Right.
Well, adjust it a little bit. Don't make it such a drastic change. And make it more, you know, just a little bit
manageable
of change here and there.
Yeah, because that's more my wife's style, and I'm more like, let's just cold turkey this, get it done.
Yeah,
you know?
But do you notice that you fail every time?
No, I'm doing good.
No, you just said.
Oh, at the end, yeah. I mean, yeah, at the end. Well, everyone does.
Stick with it.
No one does.
Oh my gosh. Yes, they do. If you make tiny little adjustments, eventually you can change your lifestyle.
I will say this, the best advice I ever heard about, like, say, a diet or some kind of resolution is don't make a resolution that only a dead person can keep. And I was like, what does that mean? By that, they mean, like, I'm never eating chocolate cake again. Like, that is so unrealistic for 99.9% of the people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm only going to walk to work. Well, it's going to rain and you're going to get in the car. And then you're going to feel bad that you broke it. So have the expectations be manageable, you know, and stuff like that. So maybe that helps you out a little bit as well. I don't know. I'm so hungry I can't even see straight. So I'm probably just talking gibberish right now. Uplifting WayFM, this is The Wally Show, and you never know how God's going to use something from your past in your life into your present. Like for me, when I worked at Radio Disney, I had no idea that that was going to prepare me for doing Christian radio years later, when I had, wasn't even a thought in my head. And I'm sure Betty Rock had no idea that all those years in preschool teaching was going to pay off for her today.
Yeah, I worked at a daycare for 6 years before I came here to WayFM, and I worked with preschool children.
Yes, you did.
It has helped a lot working with Wally, a 55-year-old grown man. I've realized that he needs a lot of motivation when it comes to having good behavior.
That is true. Because I tend to gravitate. I'm like Paul. Why do I gravitate to the things I shouldn't do, and I do the things I know I shouldn't do, and I don't do the things I know I should do? I'm kind of like a guy who wrote a lot of the New Testament.
Oh, wow. That's a reach. but I had to search inside in my inner preschool teacher days and think, what could I do to help motivate him? So I bought off Amazon some Good Job stickers, mm-hmm. and that seemed to do the trick.
Yeah.
But sometimes we would forget or whatever. So eventually, the other night, I just sat down and I made a sticker chart. Yes, I made a sticker chart for good behavior for Wally. Someone who should be mature enough to be able to handle his own feelings yeah. and make sure that he handles himself well. But that's not the case. He needs a sticker to tell him he's done a good job.
I did a good job today. I love it. I remember one day I messed up big time and I broke something. And I just looked at Betty in the middle of that because I was angry. And I just went, I'm not getting a sticker today. you know? And so it's like, yeah, it's motivation for me. So thank you. And I enjoy it. And I love that you bedazzled it. It's mm-hmm. fantastic.
Yeah, I'm doing what I can. But I can't be the only one that has had to come up with creative ways to get good behavior from people.
Yeah, or your kids. So let's talk about this. Maybe Betty Rock will come up with even more ways, because I know the sticker thing's going to burn out and she'll have to come up with some other thing. So 855-33-WAY-FM. We love having you on the show. That's the number, 855-33-WAY-FM. What have you done to get your kids to behave? Like, what creative measures have you gone to? Because you might really be helping Betty out, because I'm a problem child, I'll admit it. And so if you can take something that you've done with your kids and make it applicable to me as an adult, you will be helping her out big time. 855-33-WAY-FM. We'll take your call now. What have you done to get your kids to behave better?
So I actually made mommy buffs. I printed out, like, dollar bill looking things, kind of like Monopoly money, and I printed out denominations of 1 and 5 and 10, and I put different pictures of my face on the middle of it, and I would give them to my son when he did good things, and then they equate it to actual money in which he could, you know, be able to get things. So that was a way of doing allowance that was fun and creative.
I love that. And if I can get any money out of Betty Rock, that'd be even better. But she's super cheap. So I could see her setting up, like, Betty Bucks and being like, if you get enough Betty Bucks, I'll give you one compliment or something like that. Something that only pains her a little. Well, Miranda, thank you for being on the show and helping us out today. I appreciate you.
Thanks. You too.
What are other things that she could do to get good behavior out of me? Like something maybe you've tried with your kid.
Okay, so I'm sure you're not this extreme, but I did have a student that was very aggressive with other students. And I was like, what can I do to get on his level? So I knew he loved dogs.
Okay.
So I printed out a bunch of pictures of dogs, about 50 of them, laminated them. And if he had good behavior, I set an alarm and I said, okay, you get to go get a dog from the little box and add it to your notebook. And if he didn't touch another student all year.
Oh, really? That's amazing. That's a really creative way to get that to work out. Now, fortunately, I'm not aggressive, so we don't need that. But I could use the motivation. I'm trying to think of things that I would love. You could do this, but instead of pictures, Rock, literally just make a quick trip to, like, Krispy Kreme. And be like, okay,
donut.
If you're good for an hour, you get half of this donut. And then if you're good for another hour, you get another half of the donut.
Do you see, though, how ridiculous this is? This is coming from Ashley, who is a teacher of kids.
Right.
And me.
Yeah.
I'm working with a 55-year-old. That's you.
I understand that. But at the end of the day, don't you just want it to work? Like, it doesn't matter how.
Yeah, I'm just stressed. Like any mom, I'm just stressed out. It's easy to let the fear of the unknown keep us from doing something that is good for us. But going back to school might not be quite what you think.
Yeah, one of my biggest fears going back to school was I'd have to watch a ton of online lectures, and I kind of have a problem staying awake during stuff like that. But it was so different than I had imagined, and way better.
Yeah, for sure. I thought I was going to have to take a bunch of tests, which I am not a fan of. But instead, I was able to write papers, which for me was way better.
Plus, you have the flexibility to work in school around your work and life schedule. Another big fear I had is, what if I don't understand something? What do I do?
Yeah, CCU, they foster community with your classmates, and they are a great resource. And Colorado Christian University has very responsive online professors who are there to help you so you are never alone as an online student at CCU.
Learn more about how you can pursue your passion and find your calling with Colorado Christian University at ccu.edu. Colorado Christian University is a nonprofit impact partner committed to cultivating the mind without compromising the heart.
The regular news can be a steady stream of negativity.
Mischievous and deceitful. Chicanerous and deplorable.
But we like to see the brighter side of things. It's News-ish on The Wally Show.
If you are traveling and you hate the added cost of checking a bag, or you just don't want your luggage to get lost, and so you're going to go carry-on, maybe this can help you out. There's a TikTok blogger called The Carry-On Queen, and she shared a couple of her packing tips, because I know I've got some trips coming up, and I've tried variations of these things before, and so here's kind of what she's saying. Have little bags for the similar different things, like all of your cords. Put those in a little bag, because they tend to get everywhere when you're traveling. Like if you got them in a backpack and stuff, or like lip balms. For some reason, you ladies have 47 different lip balms and moisturizers, like all those in one little bag, and then those go into your bigger carry-on bag. But as far as packing, like the small roller bag, she says, put your silks, inside of your cottons and then roll them to avoid wrinkling. Do you have anything silk, Rock?
No.
I don't think so.
Nothing.
You're not a silk girl. You're wearing a Bucky's sweatshirt today.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Not a silk girl. But it does help keep them from getting wrinkled. Roll layering pieces like T-shirts. Roll them and then you stack them in your suitcase. That I do also.
I don't understand how rolling saves more room than just folding them and layering them on top of one another.
I've thought the same thing and I have tried it both ways and I found that I did get more when I rolled them. Now, the weird thing is I didn't know her next tip is take like the larger items and do fold those flat. I remember my last trip, I had this big, giant, thick sweater and I'm rolling it and I'm shoving it in there. And I'm like, this is dumb. And apparently it was dumb. So I didn't have to cram that down and roll that down. This is something that I do. I don't know if you do this when you travel, Rock, but if you got a pair of shoes in there, fill the shoes with stuff.
Oh, that's smart.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, use every nook and cranny you can get.
Absolutely. Like socks. You're packing socks anyway. Ball them up. Shove them down in the shoes.
Yeah, that's smart.
I always put my AirTag in my shoes, too.
Smart.
Yeah, I know. Choose multi-purpose shoes. For example, a shoe that you can wear to work out in and wear with other things.
I have traveled with girls that have brought like eight. Five,
not only girls.
Also men. I'm not looking at anyone specifically.
I love shoes. Shoot me. I used to travel with minimum of four pairs of shoes.
Oh my gosh.
I would bring a separate bag sometimes for shoes.
Wow, that's a problem.
I know. I've started now, I bring two. Like I have one that I'm wearing on the plane and I have one in my carry-on. And one is a little nicer pair and one's more like every day.
But do you ever find yourself on those trips being like, oh, I wish I had that one pair of shoes?
I do. Every once in a while, I'm like, daggum. I plan my outfits to match my shoes.
Oh, my God.
So, like, if I have a lot of black in that trip, then I'll take my black and gray ones and not my blue ones.
Nice.
But if I have a lot of blue, then I take my blue and then a pair of white shoes. Because, you know, even if it's after Labor Day, I don't care. I'm wearing white. Sue me. Some of the other things here is that I do is, like, I take, and I call it my kangaroo shirt. I'd wear a hoodie with pockets in the front on it. It is the best idea for traveling because then you take your AirPod, you take your phone, you take snacks. I can put a 20 ounce Coke in here and Cheetos and it all goes in your kangaroo holder pouch and then you can get on the plane. You're not fumbling for things. You already have everything you're going to put at your seat right there and then it's there the whole time.
Smart.
And then you can store it while you fall asleep and you don't want to lose your phone or your AirPods. Put them in your kangaroo pouch. So there you go. That's my tip.
First.
I'm not even a travel blogger, but you can have that one for free. Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show. And Jordan Feliz is one of my favorite artists that we play. He has so many great songs. And one of them I noticed, Jesus is Coming Back, is a great song. Jesus is Coming Back.
Yeah, catchy. Back. Love it.
Absolutely. And I'm always trying to help artists find ways to make a little bit more money because Christian artists don't make a lot of money.
They don't. And I don't know if many of them would expect a Christian radio DJ to be that helpful.
Thank you. Yeah, I appreciate you getting that. And so when I noticed that one of his songs could be turned into the perfect jingle for a company, I wanted to demo it up a little bit, and then I'll run it by him and go, hey, you should pitch this to them as a way of making a little money. But then as I was working through it, I'm like, is this the best idea, Wally, that you've ever had?
Oh.
I was a little concerned.
Well, you have to be very choosy about the company, you know, and because he is a Christian artist. And you want to make sure that the company is good.
That might be part of the problem here. I don't know if the product is something he would want to endorse, but it's still a necessary product. It's one we don't like to talk about, but we all kind of need from time to time. And so why not have a Christian artist associated with it? And so here's what I'm going to do. Okay, I'm going to play you a little bit of the song that I'm working on. I'm just demoing it up right now. And then you tell me if it's a good idea to pursue this or not. So here we go. This is a parody to Jesus is Coming Back, and it's called You Could Use Dulcolax.
Dulcolax.
Yes. For when you are constipated. So you'll hear it in a sec. You'll hear why it makes sense. Pretty good.
And when your world gets constipated, I know you're feeling so frustrated, but you know you could use Dulcolax. You could use Dulcolax.
Oh.
See, are you ready? I think things are working. We're making progress.
Ready now.
Oh.
And when your world gets constipated, I know you're feeling so frustrated.
Myself, I'm even on the fence myself a little bit if this borders on distasteful.
Yeah,
I'm not sure.
Can I give you some of my feedback?
I would love it. Thank you.
I'm just going with my gut here.
Okay, yes.
No pun intended. I would say that's a no. Like, that's a hard pass.
Okay.
And I feel like Jordan would be like, I agree, that's something I should not do.
While I value your opinion, I trust it zero, okay? I think you're off base. I think Jordan would rather buy a new Tesla from the Dulcolax money, personally, but that's just me. So, all right, you know what? If Betty Rock and I have a difference of opinion, so let's let you help me out. Should I pursue the rest of this parody or just let it go as a moment that we just shared and that was it? 855-33-WAY-FM. Love your opinion. You don't have to agree with me. It's totally fine. Should I pursue this or not? 855-33-WAY-FM.
You gotta keep your head up. Jesus is coming back. Jesus is coming back. Now don't you give up.
Uplifting Way FM. This is The Wally Show. That is Jordan Feliz's song, Jesus is Coming Back. And I made a song to that, a parody song that I thought he could use, to sell to a company to make a little extra money as a theme song for it, you know? And the company I know is a little bit questionable, and so that's why I'm asking you what you think about this. Here is a little bit of the parody song that I wrote for the company Dulcolax.
And when your world gets constipated, I know you're feeling so frustrated, but you know you could use Dulcolax. You could use Dulcolax.
It really sings, in my opinion, Rock.
It's a reach. It's a reach.
But see, we're on different pages, and that's why I want to ask other people their opinions. Like, is this something that I should pursue and give to Jordan? Like, this is a good idea? Or you're like, Wally, no, it's not a good idea. Just get off it. Go on to something else. And so if you can help me out with this, Lori, that would be awesome.
Sorry, Wally. That's a definite no.
A definite no? Really? Okay, that's what Betty said, too, and I'm just not feeling it. I think there could be something here.
Yeah, I'm not feeling that.
You're not feeling that one. Okay. Have you ever used the product before?
Actually.
Yeah, see? Okay, see, we don't want to talk about it, but, you know, and what a fun jingle it could be there for you. Well, I'm going to take a couple extra calls and see where we line up. But so far, you are on Team Betty. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Brandy, you're up. What do you think? Should I pursue finishing out this Dulcolax parody song for Jordan Feliz or let it go?
I say hard no.
Hard no, really. I mean, my barometer must have been so off. Betty said no. You're saying no. The lady before you said no. I'm really curious as to why.
Well, I feel like it kind of takes away from his original message of the song, and in a sense, maybe even makes fun of his original message.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah, that's not the intent. You know, parody songs are just using something that's really cool and is well done to make something funny and memorable, you know, as well. So, yeah, I get where you're coming from on that. I could see how people could take it that way. Yeah. And so maybe that's a good reason to not do it.
Yeah.
All right, Eileen, you're up. What do you say? Should I let it go or pursue the parody?
I love it. I haven't laughed that much in a long time.
Oh, that's good. You haven't laughed that much in a long time. That's what I'm going for. Humor, you know? And so, Betty Rock, we got one person that agrees with me. That's enough. We'll pursue it.
Eileen, you don't even know what you are supporting.
But I love it. And you got to snort from me, too. I snorted laughing.
She snorted, Rock. Like, if you snort, you know you've hit comedy gold there. So, well, I think that deserves an encore presentation. You could use Dolkalax, the parody song for Jordan Feliz's Jesus Is Coming Back. So, Dina, what's on your mind?
I'm somewhere in the middle on it, but I have a suggestion.
Yeah, go ahead.
Your ending line where it says you could use Dokalax, it doesn't sound like affirmative enough for a commercial.
Okay.
Like, it should be like reach for the Dokalax or something.
I like that.
They're trying to tell you to do something instead of, like, maybe.
Yeah, reach for the Dokalax. I like this. You're making it better. We're just workshopping it. So thank you. I appreciate the help, Dina.
Yeah, no problem. Have a nice day.
Hey, it's the Wally Show. Who's this?
Hey, Wally. This is Miriam.
What's up, Miriam?
So, look, I say yes for the Dokalax.
Why, thank you.
Because I think it takes someone very courageous to do this. Because as a Christian community, we're not used to laughing when it comes to Christianity.
Right.
I remember the first time I heard you on the radio, I was taken back because I thought you were so mean to Betty Rock. And I thought,
well, he is.
This is a Christian radio station. Why are you being so mean? And I didn't find it funny. I found it offensive.
Yeah.
But as I listened to you more, I understood, like, oh, this is his personality. He's like that kid in high school or college that would make us laugh. And you have to just understand where he's coming from.
Yeah, like I pick on my daughter, I picked on my wife, I pick on the people that I love, and trust me, Betty Rock is not unarmed in this. Betty Rock is she plays it off really sweet and cute, but that girl is a comedy killer. Like, she will definitely give it back to me.
So now I listen to you guys all the time because you start my day off in a good mood and I'm laughing.
Yeah, I think that a lot of times we get really worked up and stuff and we have to be very serious. And I think that's one of the things that people looking from the outside in don't like about Christianity. They think they have to stop being a person. And I've always wanted to be a normal person whose faith colors their life, but isn't afraid to laugh about things. You know, we don't always have to be serious, you know?
That's what the Dukalak song does. So go for it.
Well, thank you, Miriam. I appreciate that. I hope you have a great day.
You guys have a great one, too.
And now for some good news.
Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show. A little good news, giddy up. There is a lot of bummer news out there and, you know, angry news. And we like to find some of the brighter things here. Like this one, your paycheck could be getting bigger than usual. Even if you didn't get a raise, the IRS just adjusted tax brackets for the 2024 year based on inflation. So if you're making the same as last year, you got like that cost of living raise bump, you might actually have a little less money withheld out of your check for taxes.
So, yeah.
Yes, finally.
Yeah.
If something goes right in that arena. Betty Rock, good news, giddy up, go.
I love this story. There was a guy who has a popular Instagram, lots of followers, and he was going into this restaurant to pick up some food, but he noticed this guy who was getting off of his bike. He was a food delivery guy. He was getting off of his bike, and he had a boot on his foot, his right foot, because he had broken it.
Wow.
And he was still going around on his bike making those deliveries.
I love that. I admire that work ethic.
Yeah. And so the guy was like, why are you doing this? And he was like, listen, I got bills to pay. I got to do it. But the cool thing is that video that he took of the man went viral. And so many people are wanting to support him, like to help him with his bills. And so they've raised $2,400.
Nice. Right? There you go. I like when random people find something to get behind and they do some good for somebody. Mm-hmm. So there you go. There is good in the world, and that is your good news giddy up for today.
Things you didn't know you needed to know today. It's News-ish with Wally.
So there's a mom from Ohio, and she's offering some advice to parents, and I feel bad for this lady, and you should never have to give advice for this, but unfortunately you do. Her daughter kind of got bullied at school for having, get this, a generic Stanley tumbler. Stanleys have gotten out of control.
It's ridiculous. I saw a video where women and adults.
Yeah, adults, humans.
Are parading through the Target, and they're knocking each other over for these new Valentine's Day Stanleys that they just have to have. I don't understand. It is a tumbler.
Yeah.
You put water in it.
And it's not even a Yeti. I mean, the Yeti, no one can afford a Yeti, let's be honest. Those are crazy.
Expensive.
But this was the next best thing that became very trendy.
Yeah, and so now all these young kids, these girls, they all want Stanley tumblers.
So this little girl comes back. She got a Walmart tumbler for $9.99, and she thought it was cute. She liked it, so she got it for Christmas. She brings it to school all proud, like, hey, I got my tumbler. But then all the other girls, you know, or a bunch of them, start making fun of her for not having the Stanley, mug.
It's
I mean, I get it. I remember like that. It was like, for guys, it was like shoes, you know, the right shoes, or sometimes girls' clothes. Like, in high school, everybody, or junior high, elementary, everybody is like trying to differentiate themselves and stand out and they do that by tearing people down, and it's so sad. It breaks my heart.
Right. It's like you want to look individualistic, like you want to look special, but the thing is you're just looking like everybody else. Everybody has a Stanley.
And so her mom got on TikTok to encourage the parents to teach kids they shouldn't make fun of stuff like that.
Yeah.
But then this is the weird part of it, though, and I get it. I'm not going to like judge her at all. They went and bought their daughter the $35 Stanley mug so that she would fit in.
Less
And I'm like, that's not the best lesson to send. But when it's, and so on the outside, you go, well, that's not teaching your kid. Teach your kid to be who they are and stand up for themselves and don't care what anyone else thinks. Mm-hmm. But when it's your kid, you have a completely different viewpoint of that. And you're like, look, it's $35. I don't care. If it helps her make her day easier. And so I feel bad that anyone has to do that kind of stuff. But that's a tough thing to navigate. I'm not even sure what I would have done. I probably would have done what this mom did. I probably would have bought the Stanley and then maybe had a lesson for my daughter in this. I don't know what it would have been, but I would have tried to come up with something really good. Like, look, we're doing this to help you out. We shouldn't have to.
Right, but I think it's a good lesson that if you are the mom of a child, make sure that they're not making fun of the kids around them that don't necessarily have the things that are name brand. Like, let them realize that people are more than what they have.
And be that kid that stands up for the other kid. Like ingrain that in your kids, and because that changes the tone of that whole situation as well. When one of the cool kids, I never was that, that's why I did air quotes, stands up and protects the weaker one or the outcast, it really does land, and stuff. And if your kid can be that influencer in a good way, that would be a great thing to instill as kids just try to navigate the mess of school.
You want me on that wall. You need me on that wall.
Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show. Pastor Chad's here with us from the prayer wall, and we have this thing called our 7-day reset going on right now as part of our world's biggest small group. It's a quick Bible study through John that will hopefully help set a pattern of spending time in the Word. If you want to check it out, just text the word day to 91979. And so, Chad, you've had people that are commenting all over this thing, right?
Yeah, that's the great thing about world's biggest small group. It's like being in a small group where people can comment back and forth. And while we're studying the book of John, Alpheria says that reading the book of John, it has helped her to try to not control other people's relationships with God. Mm-hmm. And she said, especially my children's.
That's a hard one, too, because you have to give your kids up the older they get. You know, mm-hmm. you lose control over them. And you can't always just get them on the page where you know is good for them. But God does the same thing with us. He's like, hey, I know what's good for you, and I've even given you the map, and then you don't do it, but he still loves us through it. You know, I think that's the hard part as a parent.
The thing as a pastor I've learned over the years is not everybody follows God in the same way. It doesn't look the same for everyone. And so in the same way with our kids, it doesn't always look the same way. What draws one to the Lord is not what draws the other. And so trying to control our kids and making sure they all look the same or look like us is very difficult. So I get what Alpheria is saying, but at the same time, we do want to point them to God and point them to Jesus. So there's an encouragement, but also not a push.
So what is that prayer that you're praying for your kid? Because again, sometimes all you can do, mm-hmm. especially the older they get, is pray for them and be like, you know, Lord, this is out of my hands. I get it. This is bigger than me, and I need you in this moment. So I'm just curious, you know, because I have an older child too, and I know I have prayers for her as well. So I'm curious what yours are. 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM. If you got a perspective on this, we'll take it now. So what is your prayer for your kid, Wes?
Oh, I don't know necessarily that it would be controlling my kid. Proverbs tells us, train up the child the way he should go, and when he's old, he'll not depart from it. And what that means is find out how your child is naturally inclined and encourage him or her in that area, and pointing them always towards the Lord. Be an example. If they see you do it, if they see the parent do it, the kids are going to do it too.
Now, Wes, when you say be an example, can being a bad example also help to teach him what not to do? Is that does that count?
Well, that is a loaded question if I ever heard one.
Yeah, I'm hoping. I'm praying that that counts for something.
Wes, I like what you have going on there, too, because I've even noticed in my own life some things in my life to help improve my spiritual walk. So even just yesterday, I was walking on our treadmill, and I used it as a time to be able to pray. And it was just a very powerful time that I like to work out every once in a while. And so as I'm doing that, now I am able to talk to my kid, who also loves to walk on our treadmill, and say, hey, rather than just putting on a movie or rather than just listening to music, have you tried praying? Have you tried doing this? So as you're doing it, you're able to encourage your kids to do it. And it's not a regiment where like, hey, go walk on the treadmill and pray. But like you're saying, an encouragement because you've been doing it as well.
Well, Wes, we appreciate you weighing in on this, man. Thanks. I hope you have a great day.
Thanks. Have a great day.
I came here in a time machine that you invented.
Great Scott.
Now I need your help to get back in time.
Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show. It's Friday. We have crammed ourselves into a time machine, and it is Flashback Friday. And today we have Ashley, who's doing the hard work here, telling us where to go, like back in time musically. So, Ashley, welcome to the time machine. I think you need a nickname, kind of like Maverick and Goose and all the fighter pilots. We have time machine nicknames. Would Smashley work for you?
Smashley.
I guess so.
Yeah, I like it. Smashley it is. So,
honestly, I don't want Smashley driving the time machine because that sounds a little dangerous to me, especially if she's accident prone. No, thank you.
Well, maybe we'll let you drive Rock and she'll just tell us what song she wants to hear as we go back in time. What do you want to hear there, Smashley?
I would love to hear Flood by Jars of Clay.
Ooh, okay. This was the song that mapped this band. In what year was this, Rock?
This was back in 1995. Gavin, you were just an itty-bitty nugget of joy to your mom and dad. It was also the year that Seinfeld, Friends, ER, and Home Improvement were prime time on
Holy
TV.
Holy cow. I was working in radio back then, in mainstream radio, like regular rock stations, and we played Flood. I thought it was the I thought it was the weirdest thing. Two songs we played in mainstream rock was Flood and Jesus Freak by DC Talk back in the day.
Huh.
Yeah, so both of those made it. Why'd you pick this one, Ashley?
Well, this song came to me at a particularly hard time in my life that was especially awful and overwhelming. I had just began high school, where I was still trying to figure out where I fit in the world after being picked on throughout middle school. So when there was drama at school or at home that made me feel like I was drowning, I would blast the song whenever it came on the radio or when it came out on CD with headphones. and I'd play it on repeat where I could. And it just reminded me to seek God for hope in my darkness and despair, and that as he came to save Noah in the great flood, he would also carry me out of the storms of my life.
Oh, wow. That's really deep. I love that. That is a great song and a great reason for it. Smashly. You smashed that. You really crushed
Way
it.
Way to go, Smashly. Classic Smashly.
All right. So here you go. Back to 1995. It's Flood by Jars of Clay for Smashly on Flashback Friday.
Thank you so much.
Rain on my face. Hasn't stopped raining for days. My world is a flood. Slowly I become one with the mud.
Growing up in poverty has never been easy for children, but with the added challenges of the pandemic, conflict, and natural disasters, families around the world are facing an unprecedented food crisis. Unfortunately, those who are already hungry are now even more desperate. But by sponsoring a child through Compassion, you can help provide life-sustaining essentials such as food and clean water. And with your compassionate support, that child can not only survive, but also flourish. You can find out how and choose a child to sponsor when you click on the Compassion banner at wayfm.com.
Uplifting Way FM. This is The Rock Report with Betty Rock.
TV show host and NFL legend Michael Strahan recently announced that his 19-year-old daughter, Isabella, she was diagnosed with brain cancer. And yeah. That's so sad because at 19 years old, you have your whole life ahead of you. And for it to abruptly stop with brain cancer, it's just so sad. The type of cancer that she has is the type that's typically seen in younger people like herself, and it typically affects a person's coordination, and that's what happened with her. Isabella claims she first knew something wasn't right when she was noticing constant headaches, nausea, and an inability to walk straight.
Really? Okay.
So once her doctor determined her condition, she underwent emergency brain surgery with several rounds of radiation. And she's had to relearn how to walk and is set for chemotherapy. But the experience has given her a change in perspective. And I think that happens for a lot of us when we go through something sure. difficult. Our perspective changes and we see what's really important in life. It, compared to what we were thinking, what was important.
I saw them on Good Morning America. And, you know, as a dad, you only want your kids to be okay. And there are things that are beyond your control.
Right.
And that's where faith comes in. Honestly, that's where you're like, God, I can't handle this. I can't change this. I can't do anything to alter this. I'm going to have to claim your promise of peace mm-hmm. in all the things that I don't understand. And that's how you can at least walk through the unimaginable.
Mm-hmm. Well, Isabella did say, she said, quote, I'm grateful just to walk or see friends, because when you can't do something, it really impacts you. And I think that's a good lesson for all of us. Like, we take for granted the fact that, oh, I can just walk over here and see my friends, or, oh, if I want to do this, I can just do it. But we need to be grateful for the healthy bodies that we have. Her father, Michael, claims that while he thought he'd be able to handle it, because, I mean, he's a big guy,
right.
he's tough, and he wanted to be tough for his family, he has realized that he needs support too. And thankfully, they've all been able to gather around as a family, support one another,
sure.
and they've been able to depend on some close friends and extended family.
Absolutely. Yeah, it was really sad seeing her, you know, without her hair, you mm-hmm. know, and him with her and things like that. You feel for her in mm-hmm. that instance, for sure, as she tries to navigate that. But it's good. It sounds like the family's locked in together.
Right.
I don't know where they stand faith-wise at all. I have no idea. But that'd be an interesting part of this if that comes out later, that's one of the things, because I'll tell you, man, there's something about something tragic that will turn your eyes to God. And there are times I pray, you know, in my own life, like, Lord, please let me learn this lesson, help me learn this lesson before it takes me to my knees,
right?
But then he goes, remember how stubborn you are, and he's like, I'll see you in a little bit, we'll see how this plays out, you know, because sometimes that's the only place we do learn
mm-hmm.
our dependence on God, is when we can't control the situation anymore. Well, there you go. That's going to do it for your Rock Report. Thank you, Lady Rock.
Working for a living, living and a working. I'm taking what they're giving because I'm working for a living.
Up
Uplifting Way FM. This is The Wally Show. We like to play a game called Day Job because we see these celebrities on screen and all of their glory, but we forget that they were kids sometimes and just trying to make it as young adults, and they had other jobs before the big screen. Betty Rock, before you became super famous, I know you did daycare for a lot of years. Mm-hmm. What was another job you did?
I worked at a chiropractic place. Okay. So I was the person that you would see when you first walked through the doctor's office.
Oh, nice. Well, that would be a wonderful, smiling, happy face to greet you before mm-hmm. the worst thing in the world happens to your back, where they crack you.
That's where they also fired me.
Oh, that's right, because I remember this. You wouldn't get adjusted.
Yeah, it scared me to death. And they didn't tell me that was one of the things that came with the job, is that they wanted every one of their employees to get adjusted so that they could tell their customers how great it is.
Yeah.
But it freaked me out so bad that they ended up firing me.
I get it. I wouldn't want to get adjusted if I didn't want to. No way. Absolutely not.
So I didn't.
Well, that was just one of her many failed jobs.
Hey.
And so Cracker Barrel 3 days. Remember that?
Oh, I forgot about that.
Oh,
that's
not
true.
Me. I'll never forget about that. Did you keep the apron?
No, I couldn't.
Three
they
glorious
took it from
days
me.
At Cracker Barrel.
I wasn't even there long enough to get my own apron.
So we're going to give you a couple celebrities here, and we'll give you some choices as to what they may or may not have done. And then all you have to do is tell us what job you think they held. And if you get 2 out of 3 right, you can win a prize. So we need someone to play with right now. 855-33-WAY-FM. You can win a prize here. 855-33-WAY-FM. Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show. Christy, welcome to the day job game. Now, we always see celebrities and we think they're so glorious, but they had humble jobs just like us. At one point in time, they were ham and eggers too, just getting it done. And so I'm going to give you a few celebrities and I'll give you some options, and you just try to tell me what job you think they had, okay?
Okay.
Now, here we go. We're going to start with TV personality Whoopi Goldberg. Do you think that Whoopi Goldberg was a morgue beautician, a tour guide, or a personal trainer? What do you think?
I'm going to say a morgue beautician.
What makes you say that? Is it because how she does her makeup currently, or?
No, just watching over the years, I just feel like that's something she probably would do. Like,
well, I can tell you this. She was not a tour guide. Not a personal trainer. She was a morgue beautician.
Ew.
Yes. What a great job, huh?
What? No.
Well, no one can complain. Like if you're,
that's true.
If you're doing hair and, you know, normally you got clients that get angry, you know, it's pretty easy.
Right?
All right, here we go. You know him from a lot of great movies, Gerard Butler. So what do you think? Was he a lawyer, a hand model, or a carpenter?
Let's go with carpenter.
A carpenter. He seems pretty burly, like he would wear flannel.
Uh-huh.
He definitely doesn't seem like a dainty hand model. So he was not a hand model. Unfortunately, not a carpenter.
What?
He actually has a law degree and was working as a low-grade law job guy.
All right.
Well, you know what? You're 50-50. You got to get this one right. Tim Allen. Tim the Toolman Taylor. And then he went on to have that other show, too, Last Man Standing, where he owned a sporting goods company. So what do you think? Tim Allen, was he a taxi driver, a tour guide, or a salesperson?
Let's go sales guy.
Sales guy, okay. You know what? The irony of this is he absolutely was a sales guy at a sporting goods store.
No.
Yeah, I'm not making this up. And so basically, maybe that was the inspiration for his show, Last Man Standing, all those years later. Well, congratulations, Christy. You are a delight, and it is wonderful and my pleasure to hook you up with a prize for winning our day job game today.
Well, thank you very much. That was fun.
Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show, and with each new day, it feels like a reset. Like, you can have a really bad day, and you're like, all right, you know what, tomorrow's going to be new, another chance to start over,
yeah.
Do things the right way, and, you know, years are like that. You get into a new year, you start thinking like that, but there's no reason to wait just for these times to have a reset in your faith, and that's why we came up with our 7-day reset. You can join us by listening to Way FM for 7 days straight, see how that alters you, and it might, you know, you start putting in, you know, there's a concept of, you know, what goes in is what comes out. And, you know, the Bible talks about this a lot. Like, if you fill your mind and your heart with the things of God, when pressure comes and stress comes, that's what's going to come out.
Well, and you hear it a lot, too, of people that are battling with anxiety. You know, anxiety is running rampant. And one of the fixes for that is reading our Bible and realizing, getting a different perspective, a holy perspective of, like, God is the one that's in control. Maybe you found yourself dealing with depression or anxiety. Maybe you need that 7-day reset. If you do, you can text the word day, D-A-Y, to 91979. That's day to 91979. And when you do that, we're going to send you a link that will take you straight to the 7-day reset.
Yeah, it's a world's biggest small group. You'll go through the book of John, and it's a very little bit of, reading and stuff like that. It's low impact, too. So it's not like this big thing, and you're getting into this doctrinal dissertation. It's just designed to kind of get you into the Word. And I love when people are commenting about this after they've gone through it. And, it said, a moment to reflect. This is Christina. To reflect on God daily is never a waste of time. I love that. But then you've got someone that's like, I need this reset because I'm losing hope and finding myself questioning if God is even real anymore.
Oof,
so you've got two very different ends of the spectrum, both going through the same thing, and both will get something out of it if they do it, you know? And so you can do it as well. It's our 7-day reset, world's biggest small group, and check it out by texting the word day to 91979. And there's a fun little thing at the end. If you actually complete the 7 days, you have a chance to win a trip to see Lauren Daigle for a weekend of concerts. How great is that? It's just a fun little thank you for going through this. So check it out, day to 91979.
Well, that's the end, but it doesn't have to be. Check out our Aftercast. It's new stuff you didn't hear in the podcast. Be sure to rate us on iTunes as well as connect with us on social media. Just search Wally Show. And if you'd like to join our Facebook group made exclusively for you potties, the link is in the description of this podcast. Thanks to Colorado Christian University Online for supporting what we do.